That must be one of the missing altered items. Wait, how did I get back here? Altered item to worry about. That's no normal piece of paper. Okay, we need to know where it's gonna end up. I need to find the other pages.
Look at it. 8 inches wide and capable of storing a whopping 80 kilobytes.
Should be one more page. Thank you. to know where it's gonna end up.
Duty down here. This place is fucking weird.
This is nothing. The clocks?
I finished synthesizing the samples.
What's weird about a bunch of clocks?
Ingest this pill, then go and find the source of the mold. Only there can we begin to understand how to stop it.
So you promise I won't end up walking around covered in mold?
Ugh, the pill will prevent any biological infection by the mold.
Take a mystery pill because a rude lady in a hazmat suit tells you to. Great idea, Jesse.
Ugh. Honestly, did you want me to wrap it in cheese? Not the taste, the smell. It stinks in here now. Good. That means the pill is working. The worse it smells, the safer you'll be. Now go. Find the source.
Thanks for the information.
My pleasure.
I hate guard duty down here. This place is fucking weird.
This is nothing. The clocks? No, that's weird.
What's weird about a bunch of clocks?
Shut up! I think that's the new director. Once. Bleach did the trick. Has Underhill tried bleach?
I'm eager to hear what you find below the pit.
Have you worked with Emily Pope?
Our paths have crossed. Darling arranged for us to have a coffee. A meeting of the minds, he called it. She's talented. I can certainly see her doing well here.
I feel like there's a butt coming.
But she's drunk a bit too much of the Bureau's proverbial Kool-Aid. She shouldn't be afraid to forge ahead on her own. Science is skepticism. Everything must be questioned before the truth can emerge.
So, is Darling your boss?
If you insist on clinging to such outdated hierarchies, then... yes. However, I would argue that our fields are too dissimilar for one to manage the other. Of course, Darling would much prefer to find his own miracle solution to the Bureau's fungal frustrations. He always needs to be the hero.
So tell me again how you came to work at the Bureau?
Well, like I said, I was brought in as a special advisor, a temporary position, you see. Although that's not the whole truth. I was employed here for a time, straight out of university. After a decade of admittedly fascinating work in threshold research and regulation, I began to chafe under the bureaucracy. I needed a change. Not that academia was so different.
And then the mold happened.
About 4 months ago, yes. Since my departure from the Bureau, they hadn't been able to find my equal in threshold analysis. Darling and I had kept in touch over the years, meeting at conferences and the like. He called me, and I booked a flight. I've never been able to say no to a man with a dangerous alien biosphere. I had to leave my post in the middle of term, but so be it.
So she's a professor. That explains a lot.
The mold seems to be having some weird effects on things.
Indeed. Even people are susceptible. The fungus grows rapidly within the chest cavity, killing the host. Luckily, one must ingest the stalks to become infected.
Don't eat the mold. Okay.
We've always cremated the infected bodies after autopsy, but I believe there may be another stage of maturity. A blooming, if you will.
I never thought the word blooming would sound so horrible.
Thanks for the information.
My pleasure.
No need to hurry back.
This must be the pit Underhill was talking about.
Ranger Captain, Note 7.25. Underhill sent us down this weird-ass threshold looking for whatever's making all these vegetables sprout. I will say this.
Oh, God. Where do I go? What does it smell?
Thank you.
MGA Ranger Gap Depth Note 7.28. Wait. Six, seven, whatever. Still in the threshold. Always get up eating the vegetables now, because eat your vegetables.
Is that the source? It's kind of pretty. Is that the source? It's kind of pretty. Nope. No.
Stop being surprised by all the weird shit in this place.
down there. We don't want to have to come save you.
Seriously. You've returned, I see. And you're not sprouting mold from your eyes. I take it that means my pill worked. Now tell me everything. Did you find the source? You did, didn't you?
I found a big, angry plant. Like, gigantic. I killed it.
You killed it? You found the source and you killed it? I could have learned so much from a live specimen.
Her concern is touching. Really, it's too much.
Here, I brought you a sample.
A piece of the innermost mold. You're not such a lost cause after all. Strange. So different, even superficially. Another stage of growth, perhaps.
Please, no more stages.
You'll be pleased to know that cutting down the creature at the source has already resulted in a notable cessation of the mold's rapid growth. You've bought me time for further study.
So what now?
I'm glad you asked. While you were busy in the pit, a number of mold hosts were sighted beyond the threshold. They managed to sneak out without the Rangers noticing. There's a reason I didn't send Steve and Andy to find the mold source with the others. These vagrant hosts must be eradicated as soon as possible. The mold can still be spread by their overgrown bodies.
Any idea where they went?
The hosts I've observed are not a sprightly bunch. Here are the reports I've received. They'll help you find them.
I'll go take care of them.
Good. And do be quick about it.
There's a nice way to say that.
Thanks for the information.
My pleasure.
Thank you.
I should let Underhill know.
New pill, right?
Pill? What pill? Don't you dare.
I found the hosts. They won't be spreading any more mold.
Well done. I'll send burn teams to sanitize the locations. I'm beginning to wonder if these hosts are originating outside the threshold in independent patches of mold growth.
You don't sound very optimistic.
Optimism is for farmers, as my mother always said. I suppose you could now return to that hiss business you all seem so concerned about.
This woman has some incredible tunnel vision.
Thanks for the information.
My pleasure.
She had to write everything in her made-up gibberish code. Fucking Marshall.
I found this token. Any idea what it does?
That is a jukebox token. Little bastards turn up in the weirdest places. Like bad pennies. The Rangers use them to activate an old object of power.
A jukebox, I assume. Does it have any good songs?
Nope. Just the one record. Hey, be careful turning it on, though. When it's playing, get a free trip to the formation.
The formation? That sounds ominous.
Why does it send you there?
The Bureau has been wondering that for years. I mean, it's just a pile of rocks built by God knows who, but... Well, researchers have confirmed it's in the same threshold as the quarry. Well, no one's ever been able to map a physical route to the formation for maintenance.
So it's in the quarry. You just don't know where.
Pretty much. We only send in annual expeditions to the formation now. Checkups, Salvador calls them. This year's team went in the day the hiss arrived. Come to think of it, the song should have brought him back hours ago.
I can go in and take a look.
I'd appreciate that. The jukebox is kept just past the security booth over there. Just put in the token and enjoy the ride.
What's the deal with BlackRock?
Oh, fuck. Don't get me started on BlackRock. You know, ever since research found out that it blocks paranatural stuff, they have just been parading dangerous materials in and out of the fucking quarry. Fucking lab coats, man. Love making my job harder.
Sounds like there's some tension between departments.
Still, at least the quarry's got a good view of the night sky. You know, me and Salvador used to have after-work beers down there.
What do you know about Dr. Darling?
About as much as anybody, I guess. Head of research, loves to hear himself talk. All of those science types absolutely do. He's been acting a little bit psycho recently. Although HR told me not to use that word, so...
Everyone thinks finding Darling will lead us to the answers. But if he's completely lost it, then what help could he be?
You're security, right? Do you work with Rangers?
Not often. Rangers are specially trained in threshold reconnaissance and ground zero AWE response. Security is more interested in the dangers inside the Bureau.
They must see some weird stuff out there.
Oh yeah, definitely.
You know, every week they are tackling things that were previously unknown to the human experience. Most Rangers, they retire due to cognitive collapse. I looked up the medical definition. Not fun.
How does the Bureau handle thresholds?
Handle might be a bit of an optimistic way to put it. Marshall sends a Rangers in to map them, check growth rates, locate epicenters, take samples, measure stuff, basically.
Sounds like he's done his homework.
Now, down in maintenance, thresholds are used just like any other tool. Lab coats mine black rock from one, maintenance siphons water from another. We use it for pretty much everything, except drinking.
Why don't you drink it?
Do I even want to know?
Yeah, a lot of time we find these little chunks in it. It's pretty gross.
I didn't want to know.
What do you think of Marshall?
Marshall? Marshall's a fucking badass. Rangers could not ask for a better leader. She's a little, intense, but given the stuff she's seen, I'm not surprised. She does have a bad habit of disappearing, though.
Where does she go?
Last time she vanished, I did some digging into the security logs. I found camera footage of her entering the quarry. She was down there alone for days. Now, typically that's not allowed, but Marshall is kind of above the rules.
I wonder what she finds so interesting in the quarry.
I have to go.
Me too. You're not the only... Oh my god, did she have to write everything in her made-up gibberish code? Fucking Marshall.